This is another Infographic Instant with your host, Brian Michael. And today we're going to be looking at wealth and how wealth comes from estate planning. Before starting our discussion of this infographic, we should note that the data come from Dinardi, 2002, as part of the background to a fuller paper which we provide a link to, you'll see below the infographic. So let us turn our attention to the graph now and see what it tells us about wealth and estate planning. We see three main strata of affluent and high net worth individuals, namely those holding the top 1% of wealth in a country, top 5%, and top 10%. And it shows a comparison between the United States and Sweden. So the bars you're looking at are actual wealth in these various wealth strata, and that's depicted by the solid green bars. And you see next to those bars two different parameterizations of the model that these authors use. And the model they use assumes some amount of bequesting, or leaving an inheritance to future generations, and no bequesting. And what we observe is that models that allow for giving inheritances explain the actual evolution of wealth much better than those that do not. So if we want to understand the dynamics of wealth in any economy, we have to look at inheritances. Now, what does this mean for financial advisors? This means that estate planning is probably the way to grow a book of business. Assume that as a financial advisor, you want to develop your clients over time. Naturally, the more assets they accumulate, the more commissions and fees the financial advisor can earn. Well, that means that if they can provide inheritance planning and other services around delivering wealth from one generation to the next, that will help to secure those assets in those accounts, and that will help the financial advisor manage increasing amounts of assets over time. This has been an Infographic Instant with Brian Michael.